Hey everyone, Mike Mulligan here from Blind on the Move, and welcome to Lesson 2 of my VoiceOver Video Training Series. Lesson 2 is a really basic lesson, but very important, and that is how do you turn VoiceOver on and off. And there are four different methods I'm going to show you today, and they're all pretty easy to do. That way you have the option of accessing VoiceOver whichever way works best for you. So let's get started. As a quick reminder and recap of Lesson 1, VoiceOver is Apple's built-in screen reader that allows somebody who's blind or visually impaired to be able to interact with their screen using gestures and speech feedback. If you haven't checked out Lesson 1, I definitely recommend doing that. And now let's get into how to turn VoiceOver on and off. So let's dive into these four different methods for turning VoiceOver on and off. I just want to mention that I am using an iPhone 16e for this demonstration. So depending on what version of iPhone you have, there might be some slight variations, and I'll try and cover those while I'm going through the different methods. But overall, they're going to be very similar to what I demonstrate here. So first method I want to show you is probably the easiest and the one I use the most, and that is just to ask Siri to turn VoiceOver on and ask Siri to turn VoiceOver off. So I'm going to demonstrate here. Hey Siri, turn VoiceOver on. And to confirm, I could just tap the screen at the top.
VoiceOver, accessibility, switch button, on. So, double tap to toggle setting.
So now VoiceOver is on, and if I want to turn VoiceOver off, all I need to say is, hey Siri, turn VoiceOver off.
Okay, I turned VoiceOver off.
So very simple, easy to use, but it does require you talking. So in some situations that might not be appropriate. So let's go on to method two. And for method two, what you're gonna do is go through the settings menu to turn VoiceOver on and off. And I just wanna mention to make sure you have your volume on when you're doing this so you can confirm when it is getting turned on and off. So step one here is going to settings. So I'm gonna find the settings icon, tap on that. After I do that, I'm going to scroll down until I get to the accessibility menu. I'm going to tap on that. And that now brings me into all the different accessibility settings on the iPhone. And what we're looking for here is VoiceOver, which is the top one under the vision category. So I'm going to tap that. And once I'm in here, there's a lot of different tweaks and settings you can do to VoiceOver itself, which we'll cover in future lessons. But simply to turn it on, you tap the toggle switch at the top.
VoiceOver on, settings, accessibility, back button.
So that turned it on, and now if I want to turn it off, I'm going to tap.
VoiceOver, switch button, on.
And it said switch button.
Double tap to toggle setting.
So then, what, like it just said, I will double tap to toggle the setting, and I can double tap anywhere on the screen.
VoiceOver off.
And there we go. So now VoiceOver is off using method two. And now for method three, this one takes a little configuration in the beginning, but once it's set up, it can make accessing VoiceOver much easier. So the way this works is you need to set it up by going to settings. So I'm gonna tap on settings. That brings me to the main settings menu. I'm gonna go down to accessibility, tap on that. And then I'm gonna scroll down and there will be towards the bottom, the second actually from the bottom, is accessibility shortcut. So I'm going to tap that, and it gives you a lot of different options for setting up accessibility shortcuts. But really what this does is when you set it up, if you triple click the side button on the phone, it will open up an accessibility shortcut menu. And if you still have an older iPhone with the home button, you can do the same thing and triple tap that three times and it will open up the accessibility shortcut menu, which I'll show you here in a second. But first I want to toggle VoiceOver onto that accessibility shortcut. So I'll scroll down, second from the top is VoiceOver. I'm gonna tap on that. And now there's a check mark to the left of that. And we're all set. So I'm gonna go back to my home screen and I'm gonna triple tap, and I'm gonna do this best I can, and I'm going to triple tap, and that should open up an accessibility shortcut. So let me do that now.
VoiceOver on, weather, Manchester, current location, 55 degrees Fahrenheit, mostly sunny, high of 63 degrees.
So because VoiceOver was the only one that was checked, it automatically turned VoiceOver on when I hit this side button here on the phone three times. Pretty quick succession. So it takes a little practice getting used to that. Several times I'm too slow and I don't get all three pushes in time. But now that's on, if I want to turn it off, I can come back here to the side button.
VoiceOver off.
And now VoiceOver is off. So that is method number three. And then lastly here, we have method number four, and this one only works with iPhones with an action button. So above the volume buttons, the action button is now in replace of where there used to be a little toggle switch to turn volume on and off. So again, this is an iPhone 16e, and that's why it has an action button. But the action button is actually a really nifty tool because it could be customized to all different types of actions. So I'm going to show you here how to create the action button as a VoiceOver on and off button. So the way it works is this takes some customization as well, but I'll go to settings. I'm going to scroll down until there's a section that says action button. I'm going to tap that. And this gives you a big menu. So I already have the action button as a tool for VoiceOver, but I'm just going to show you some of the other options. So if I swipe left, there's controls, recognize music, flashlight. So there's a lot of different customization for the action button, which I think is pretty cool. But let's go back to VoiceOver. So when you get to accessibility, there's a menu you can go through to customize that accessibility on the action button to what you want. So there's zoom, there's smart invert, there's a lot of different things, but I've selected VoiceOver, so there's a check mark next to it. So now that that's set up, I'm going to go back to the home screen, and I'm going to just hold down that action button.
VoiceOver on, weather, Manchester, current location, 55.
So now VoiceOver is on by holding that action button, and to turn it off, go to the action button, hold it down.
VoiceOver off.
And now VoiceOver is off. So that's a really easy and simple way once it's set up to turn VoiceOver on and off. And that's it. Now you know four different ways to turn VoiceOver on and off. One is just to ask Siri. Two is to go into settings and accessibility and turning VoiceOver on. Three is setting up that accessibility shortcut. Four is using the action button on the iPhone 16 series. So each method has its benefits. So I definitely recommend checking each one out and see which one works best for you. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this video was helpful in learning a little bit more on how to turn Siri on and off. In the next lesson, we will be focusing on how to unlock the phone using VoiceOver gestures when VoiceOver is on. So looking forward to having you in lesson three. Have a great day.